Different unfair malpractices. We have seen that the political parties, they take them so that they can win the election. Here in this video I will discuss the what are the reasons why we can say that our country's election, I repeat, our country's election is called democratic. Clear? Because of three reasons, remember: due to role of EC, that is Election Commission, I will discuss in detail, then popular support, and third one is acceptance of election outcome. Due to all these three reasons, we can ensure that in India the election is called democratic. Clear? Now first, that is aspect we'll discuss as first reason, that is called EC. EC means Election Commission. What is that? It is an independent body who regulates or conducts election. Now let us analyze who is the head of Election Commission. CEC is the head of election Election Commission. CEC stands for Chief Election Commissioner. Okay, Chief Election Commissioner, and he gets appointment by President. Remember, so Election Commission is an independent body, because while election, there will be what question in your mind, what I feel that in our country we can say that election is a democratic, our country's election what procedure is called democratic. But different type of questions may rise in your mind, that what type of election it is, who conducts the election, then does it have any power, does it work under the government or it is independent. These all type of questions will come in your mind. So it's all the answer of all this question is called one, that is called Elections Commission. In our country, Election Commission conducts the election. Okay, and remember, who is the head of Election Commission? That is CEC, or Chief Election Commissioner. And it is not elected or selected, it is appointed. He is appointed by President, and once President gave the appointment, then even he is getting the appointment by the President. But after what President appointment also, when it being the powerful, when he come to power, then even he will not listen to President as well. He will also, but in future he will not listen to the President's order. That means why? Because it is independent. Now clear? Understood? So once it comes to power, even the President is also cannot influence the work of Chief Election Commission, or you can say Election Commission, the independent body. Now let us analyze, once got the appointment, what are the functions or power of Election Commission of EC. The first is, number one, it makes decision on all type of work related to what? Election. That means it conducts, it makes any changes, it makes all type of what the decisions related to elections. Okay? Number two, implements the code of conduct. It implements the code of conduct on the political parties or the candidates. Whoever, I repeat, whoever violates it, if anyone is violates this code of conduct, then they'll be punished. Clear? That means punishment is given if anyone is breaking the code of conduct. What is code of conduct? Code of conduct means some of the guidelines which is made by the ISI to be followed by whom? To be followed by the political parties or individual candidate, those who are contesting in the election. Okay? Next, number third one is government cannot misuse its power for winning the election. That means the government also follows certain guidelines. Remember, that means government also cannot misuse, because presently here government means what? The ruling party. That means presently whoever is in power, it cannot, because abhi to powerful mein hai na, abhi wo power mein hai, then it cannot what prevent any candidate or what misuse its power to win the coming election. Okay, this is third one. Then the fourth one, all government workers or officers, they work under ISI, not under government. Means now presently during the election, all government, particularly the government employees, are allowed to do the all type of electional activities. So here the government workers, they will be doing all the activities or everything they'll do related to election, and they will not report to the government, rather they'll report to whom? The EC or election commission. One most important, remember another function it is there. You can remember, it can reject or cancel any type of, it cancel the election. Sometimes whatever, how it cancels the election, sometimes it what happens, if it come to the notice of EC that reported by some of the officials, government official, that in some of the constituencies due to the malpractices some parties have won the election, in those constituencies what it will do, it will cancel or cancel what the election. That means once again it will give order to that constituency to re-poll or re-election. Once again election will be conducted in such constituency, not all constituency where this malpractices has done. So these all are called the functions of EC. I repeat, these all are called the functions of EC. Once remember why this all functions it is doing, all type of functions it is doing. It is doing because it is independent. Because even you know that the government is also, whether government like or dislike, it is not bothering to whom? The EC or election commission, because it is independent and powerful. And even once it is getting appointment from the president, the president's order also it may cancel, it may reject, okay, may not listen to the what decision made by the president. Clear? So why and how it works, I repeat, how it works, like our judiciary, I have told we have three organs. One is legislature, executive and judiciary. And judiciary also works independently, neither under the pressure of legislative executive. Similarly, your EC also works like this. judiciary. Similarly, what judiciary as it takes independent decision, EC also takes independent decision, but what during the election.